Hello everyone. So today we are going to discuss about the programming. We'll basically try to find the answers of these questions. What is programming? Then why do we need programming? What are the languages to write them? And finally, I'll introduce you the C programming language. So without any further ado, let's get started. Always. So what is programming? Programming is nothing but writing some instructions to instruct the computer to perform the specific task. And this set of instructions is known as the program. For example, computer has the operating system which is responsible for handling hardware as well as software resources. Like it has memory management program which is responsible for managing all the interactions with the memory. Similarly, file management programs for handling the files and so on. These programs are basically known as the system level programs, but we also had application level programs, for example, a music player, which is used for playing the musics. What basically I am trying to say is that whatever the actions performed by the computers are nothing but the programs only. Consider the following diagram. Here, this is nothing but set of instructions written in any programming language. We'll discuss programming languages later. And this whole set of instructions or a file is known as a program. Computer will take this program as an input and then execute it and finally produce some output. Alright, so far we understood what is programming and what a program looks like. But still we have many questions in our mind, like how would we write these instructions, means in which language do we have to write these instructions? Is it natural language like English or similar one? So for getting better answers of these questions, we'll first see the language of the computer, means what is the language that computer actually understand. Like we as a human being are able to understand natural languages, or we can say the human based languages. Similarly, computer has their own language which is nothing but the binary language. So what is binary language? Let's see. First of all, the computer is nothing but an electronic device or a component, and every electronic device have only two states, either it is on or off. And these on and off situations, we are logically representing them by 1 and 0. See this figure here, when the power is on, this is logic 1, otherwise we say the logic is 0. This is what we called as a binary language. Binary language only consists of zeros and ones, or the sequence of zeros and ones. If you are a user of a computer, you must have heard about the 32-bit system or 64-bit system. Basically, a bit represents a single binary digit, which is why it is called as a bit, which can be either 0 or 1. 32 bits means a combination of 32 bits containing zeros and ones. You also have heard about the sizes of the memory, such as MBs, megabytes, GBs and KBs. So what exactly they are? Mega, giga, kilo and bytes all are the units. But here the most important unit is the byte. For example, a kilobyte is nothing but 1024 bytes. Similarly, we can calculate other values also, such as megabytes, gigabytes or terabytes, etc. So what exactly the byte is? A byte is the standard representation of a single unit that can be used for representing numbers or characters inside the computer. The byte is nothing but the sequence of the 8 bits, and logically we are representing it as like this. There are 8 empty blocks and each box can have zeros and ones in it. These small boxes basically representing the single bit. Let's see some examples. For example, how can we represent these numbers through binary, such as 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. So 1 basically represent as like this in binary. Believe it or not, but this is what computer is stored for representing 1 inside the memory. We represent 2 as like this, similarly 3 and 4. But before showing you the further numbers, first we'll see what is the logic behind it. So basically these all blocks has their own values as like this. These numbers represents the actual value of that particular bit from right to left. Just ignore this part as of now. If needed, I'll definitely let you know. So for example, if we consider first bit, if it is 0, it means the value is 0, and if it is 1, it means the value is 1. But for this bit, If it is 0, then it means the final value is 0, but if it is 1, the final value will be 2. And why 2? Because this box has its value as 2 to the power 1. Basically, if any bit of this block is 1, then we will consider their respective values. For example, if this bit is 1, it means the value of this bit is 8, otherwise 0. Let's see some more examples. When this bit is 0, the value will be 0 as we discussed. But if it is 1, this will represent the value as 4 and so on and so forth. Now, let's again represent these values with the recent logic. 1 will be written like this, there is no doubt. Then 2 will be written like this, as this bit is 1 and the value of this bit is nothing but 2. Similarly, 3 will be written like this, as these both are 1, so the value of this block is 2 and the value of this block is nothing but the 1. So after summing them up, we get 3 as a result, means 2 plus 1 is 3. Then we can write 4 in this way. Here only this bit is 1 and the value of this bit is 4. Similarly for other ones. I hope you get the idea. Let me check. How can we represent number 19 in the binary? Exactly, it will be written like this. Here the value of this bit is nothing but the 16. And as we know, we can write 3 in binary as like this. So after summing them up, it will be 19. Now we got better understanding of binary language. Let's write a rough program to add 2 binary numbers. In binary, we'll write it like this. Here, this plus sign is also has some binary representation. Instead of getting in much details, let be it like this only. Now, give this program to the computer as an input. As the computer can understand this program very easily now, it will execute it and give us a result as like this, which is nothing but the 5. But should we have to write this code in this way? Or will you be able to write any other programs using only zeros and ones? The answer is definitely no, because it will take much time to write it, and also this will be full of errors and bugs. So what is the solution? We as a human being can only understand natural languages, for example English, but the machine or computers can only understand the zeros and ones. So what to do? Here the programming languages comes into the picture. The programming languages are designed to write the code that is understandable by human being. These codes are written using human based languages such as English, but these languages also have their own syntaxes. Syntax is nothing but writing the code in some predefined manner or using some rules of that particular language. But again, as computer can only understand zeros and ones, which is also known as machine code, programming languages has their own compiler or interpreter or assembler to convert their written code to the machine understandable code. We'll discuss these terms such as compiler, interpreter and assembler later. First, let's see what are the programming languages we have and their features and applications. There are basically plenty of programming languages available nowadays. Some of them could be C, C++, Java, Python and so on, and the list will go on. So I'm going to discuss about C language here. Other languages will be covered under their own topics. So what is C language? The C programming language was first released back in 1972. It's a high-level procedural language that has become one of the most widely used ones out there. Despite its age, it's still a relatively complex language, yet its influence can be seen in many others. C#, C++, Java, Python and more all take elements of inspirations from the C. So there are some features of C language, such as simple and efficient. The syntax styles of C programming is easy to comprehend and they can be used to design applications that were previously designed by assembly language. One can grasp the concepts of C language very easily. Then it has speed. Since it is a compiler based language, it is comparatively faster than other programming languages like Java or Python, which are interpreter based. So here the question arises, what is compiler or interpreter or assembler? So generally speaking, these all are the tools for converting the code written by us into the machine understandable code. Some programming languages use the compiler, for example C and C++. Some languages uses their interpreter such as Python, and some of them uses both interpreter as well as compiler. The best example of this is nothing but the Java, and the assembler are used by the assembly languages. Now let's move to the next feature, which is existence of the libraries. C language comprises of its libraries, which has a wide range of built-in functions. For example, printf and scanf functions, which we use almost in all our programs for taking input and printing output to the console. Even the user-defined functions can be added to the C library. Then we have feature as statically typed. It means we are very sure about the data type that is gonna be stored by a particular variable. Otherwise, it will throw a compile time error. Then we had modularity or structured language. This feature of C language allows the program to be broken into smaller units and run individual units with the help of functions. In simple words, modular programming refers to the software design technique which increases the number of fragments of the same code. Now we'll see some of its applications. So the first application in operating systems. The first applications to be developed using a high-level programming language was Unix, which was designed in C programming language. Later on, Microsoft Windows and various Android applications were scripted in C. Then we have embedded system. The C programming language is considered an optimal choice when it comes to scripting application and drivers of embedded system, as it is closely related to machine hardware. It also has some application in GUI. GUI stands for graphical user interface. Adobe Photoshop, one of the most popular used photo editors since older times, was created with the help of C. Later on, Adobe Premiere and Illustrator were also created using C. MySQL, which is a type of database, was also written in C and C++. Then we had compiler design. One of the most popular use of the C language was the creation of the compilers. Compilers are basically used for converting the source code into machine understandable code. We already discussed that. Now it also has some application in gaming and animations. Since the C programming language is relatively faster than Java and Python, and also it is compiler based, it finds several applications in the gaming sector. Some of the most simple games are coded in C, such as Tic-Tac-Toe and the Snake Game, and many more. Now let's see the structure of the C program. Basically, program structure of C consists of 6 parts, out of which 3 are optional, but they are definitely very useful for bigger projects. Let's see them one by one. The first part is nothing but the documentation. This part is commented and consists of name of the program, then the name of the programmer, written or modified date and time. This information is very useful for another programmer to know what this program is all about. Then we have the second part as link section. This part is very important as we are including some pre-built library of the C. These libraries comes with many useful functions. For example, we don't have to think like how do we get the input from the user. We can just use this kind of function or something similar to that. Then we have the definition section, which is optional. Here we declare some constant variable that can be used throughout the program. We'll see this later with an example. Then we had fourth part, which is global declaration section. Here we declare all the global variables. Global variables can be used anywhere throughout the program or the code. We also defined or declare all the functions that we are planning to use in our code. We'll see what is defined and declared with an example code later. Then we have the most important part of the program, which is nothing but the main function. This is basically known as the entry point of our program, means code will start executing after finding this main function. Without main function, the code will never run. Then finally, we have the last part here. All the functions that we had declared earlier above will be defined, means we'll provide the definition of those functions here only. Let's see the example to better understand all these sections. Here, this is comment part, which is nothing but documentation part of the code. Second part is nothing but the link part. Here we'll include all the libraries of which we are willing to use the function. Here I only include a standard input output library, which is stdio.h, because I'm using printf function for outputting the result, and this function is packed in stdio.h library. Then we are defining a constant, although we are not using it. This is just for showing you what exactly the definition part contains. We can write here 0 or more constant as needed. Then we are just declaring the sub functions. Every function with doesn't contains its definition will be defined later after the main function. Here we also make a function with its definition, such as some functions, such as some function. These are just for demonstration purpose. There are some use cases of these declarations and definitions. By the way, we can write our functions by using both of the methods. Then finally, we have the main function. Whenever we try to execute our C program, compiler will first look for main function and start executing each line written inside the main function. For example, here, after finding the main function, it will execute the sum function and store the return value of the sum function into the result variable and then print it to the console. Then this last part contains the definition of all the functions declared above. Here, as we declared only one function, sub, we define it here in this part. Let's now run this program. Here I'm using Visual Studio Code for running C and C++ programs. If you also want to set up your VS Code for running C and C++ program, you can watch this video that I'm showing you above. You can also find the same link in the description of this video. Let's try to run this code. Here we get the sum of these two numbers. Let me call these functions also to see the output written by this function. Congratulations, we successfully wrote our first program in C to print sum as well as subtraction of two numbers. In our next video, we are gonna go in much details of these all statements and functions. That's all for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for the patience. If you like this tutorial, please click on the like button and share it with your friends. Also subscribe the channel and don't forget to press the bell icon to never miss out any incoming videos like this one. And that being said, see you in the next video.